Good. I'm glad it's feeling up to doing a few things.
May the Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Excuse me. I have a few announcements for us this morning. If you'll look at your insert in your bulletin, I'd like to thank everyone who helped, who donated, people were wonderful on helping set up, people were wonderful on helping to make sure that the yard sale was manned, all those wonderful things. They made right around $450 or $350. And we were talking, and we're going to leave it up to also be involved with the community yard sales. That got moved back this year, so it will be set up there in the back of the hallway for a couple of weeks because that's coming up Memorial Day week, first weekend there in June. We got church council Tuesday evening, and before church council at 6 o'clock, we will be having a prayer walk where we will be walking through the church praying for the different ministries and people that use the building. If you would like to join us, please do, and I would also like to remind everyone that church council actually consists of everyone who sits on our committees. So everyone is welcome to be there, and that's at council is at 6:30 with the prayer walk at 6. Wednesday we have senior luncheon at noon, youth group at 5. Thursday we have Bible study at 6, and Saturday we have a team up field day at the park where we will be getting the fields and the park ready for all the summer activities and such. Are there any announcements I'm forgetting this morning? Okay, well, if not, then we'll get to Cindy for birthdays and anniversaries.
Do we have any anniversaries we can help you celebrate today? join me in the opening prayer, an invitation to Christ, printed in your bulletin. Come, my light, and illumine my darkness. Come, my life, and revive me from death. Come, my physician, and heal my wounds. Come, flame of divine love, and burn up the thorns of my sins, kindling my heart with the flame of thy love. Come, my King, sit upon the throne of my heart and reign there, for thou alone art my King and my Lord. Amen. If you would please join me in Gloria Patri.
Thank you.
If you would, let us turn to our inserts, the backsides of the calendar, and such to our prayer list. Would we have any joys or concerns we'd like to share this morning, or updates on ones who were on the prayer list? Yes, James.
I have great joy. So today is Mother's Day, and mothers all around are very underappreciated. So to everyone in here today, I would like to say Happy Mother's Day.
What'd you get in trouble for this week, James? No, James, that is wonderful. That is a great sentiment. And yes, you should treat your mother wonderful every day. All of us should. Yes. That's just how it is, right? They gave us life. They gave us all these chances to disappoint them or make them happy. So yes, we should thank them every day. Would there be any other requests that we'd have this morning?
I have joy. It arrived April 25th. JJ and Kristen had their third child. This time they had a girl. They already had two boys. Her name is Persephone Grace.
We will keep Persephone Grace and her mother in our prayers. Would there be any others this morning? If not, well, let's go to the Lord in prayer at this time. Dearest Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you. We thank you for this day. We thank you for all the ways you've been with us in the past week, for the joy we felt as we gathered together, for being able to come before you and open our hearts. We open them to you and we place all those who are there into your hands, Lord, and we give you thanks. We give you thanks for all the wondrous ways you've been with us in the past week, and we give you thanks for your promise to be with us in the week to come. We lift up each one of these ones who are on our prayer list this morning, Lord, and we just ask that you will watch over each and every one of them, that you will be in every situation, that you will take them and those who are dear to them, and that you will allow them to know that you are with them and that you are going with them through all that they go through. We pray especially, Lord, for Persephone Grace, and we ask, Lord, that you will be with her, that you will watch over her little life, and you will keep her safe and help her to grow happy, healthy, and strong. Watch over her mother and father and allow them to be able to be good parents and to be able to do all the things that will help her to be able to grow up strong. Watch over her brothers and help them to look after her also. Watch over the entire household. We also pray, Lord, for each of us here, for our mothers, for all those who have been our mothers. We thank you for them. It is Mother's Day, and we give you praise for them. For without them, we would not have life, and we would not have life as we know it. Help us to honor them. Help us to respect them and to show them the love that they have shown towards us. And help that love that they have given to us be able to be shared with others. We pray, Lord, for our communities. We thank you for them. We thank you for the peace, the safety, the security that you pour out upon this land. And Lord, we thank you for our leaders, for those who take care of us, for those who make our days good. We ask, Lord, you will continue to move amongst our streets and keep them wonderful places for our children, our grandchildren, and our great-grandchildren. And we ask, Lord, that you will go with them all the places that they go, and that you will keep them in your hands now for all their days. We ask, Lord, that you will continue to bless our neighborhoods, that you will continue to bless our neighbors, and that you will keep your peace, your safety, and your security upon our lands. We thank you, Lord, for the opportunities that you allow us to be you to those around us, and we give you praise and thanks, Lord, for those opportunities where others are new to us. We ask that you just continue to keep your hands on our communities. We also pray, Lord, for those who are in the military. We ask, Lord, that you will be with them, that you will watch over them and care for them, We thank you, Lord, for how they defend our freedoms, and we ask, Lord, that you will surround them with your shield of strength and protection, and that you will bring them safely home to us. And we pray, Lord, for those who do not come home safely. To those who are injured, we ask that you will give your healing, both in body and in spirit. You will help them to return to the lives that they left behind. And to those who do not come home, Lord, we ask that you are with their families, that you will pour your comfort, your grace, your peace, and your strength out upon them. And you will help them to know that they and their loved ones are in your hands. Watch over each of them, Lord. We pray also, Lord, for those who are in the nursing homes. We ask, Lord, that you would be with them and that you would make their days good, that you would put joy in their hearts and smiles on their lips. We ask, Lord, that you would bless those who visit them and those who take care of them, and that, Lord, you would allow your joy to be in their hearts also, so that it is so much of your love is being shared that the halls and places filled with your joy, your laughter, and your love. We thank you, Lord, also for your church, for our place in your church, and as your children, Lord, we pray the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, if the kids would come forward for children's moments. So how you guys doing today? Not so good. Was it just a slow day? You're tired. Is that what storms and rain does to us when it storms and rains all night? We just want to stay in bed and sleep and sleep and sleep. You got up early because you were at your aunt's house. And she had to go to work, so she had to take down her. Excellent! Okay, now, I realize you're not youth age yet, but this is what I tell all the youth, and you're starting to get pretty close. If you can't run with the big dogs, stay on the porch with the puppies. Okay? So that means if you can't stay up and watch movies, you need to go to bed with the puppies, okay? Because we got to get up and do our things the next day, right? Whether we want to or not, that's one of the most amazing facts of life, that we got to get up and do the things we need to do the next day. Now, what you're supposed to be doing here now is bouncing and being happy because you got to stay up late last night. And guess what I got to do? And guess what I got to do? Right? Isn't that how we should be on a day like this now? Ouch! Ouch! You hit her. See, and you should be extra happy because you had one less sister at home. And you should be bouncing on, guess what I got to do? Guess what I got to do? How come we don't do that? How come when we've had things that are just special for us, we don't bounce and share it with everyone? Same thing with God's special love for us, isn't it? We don't always bounce. We don't always want to share it with everyone. Right? Because sometimes we prefer, well, yeah, yawn real big. We all need it. Hide it good from us, please. How many of us are those things contagious to? remind them, please, we need that. Today is the second Sunday of the month. It's Mother's Day. No, we're not talking about that yet. I'll bring you back up here in a little bit for that. We're going to do something else first. So what do you think we're doing today? It's the second Sunday of the month. 2 cents a meal. Did you bring your 2 cents a meal offering today?
No.
No? It's easy to forget. I would expect we do. We do too. See, I got this big bag to dump in your basket and make you drop it today. And it sealed up pretty good this time. Remember a couple of years ago, whenever I went to get it, it just went all over the place? Nope. Well, you were the ones picking it up most of it. You were really wonderful that morning. And it's on video, too, so there's evidence. But it's 2 cents a meal day. You know, that time where we put back each week, each day, 2 cents for each meal we eat. And then we bring it in once a month to give it to the food pantry and the West Ohio food pantry to make sure that people around us can get those things that they need. Because we like eating, don't we? Yeah, even when we're sleepy, we like eating, right? Yeah, say even when we're sleepy. So would you guys please collect our 2 cents a meal offering for us? Yes, I'm going to ask you to do double duty today. Do both sides. If he can do it, I mean, if you can do it, you're the one that stayed up too late. Right? But I'm sure you can. So if you would, Kenny has some baskets back there for you. Would you guys collect our 2 cents a meal offering?
Mother's Day.
Yeah, it is. What have you done special so far, baby? You're not a mother. Oh, okay. Okay, so Mother's Day is a day that mothers do special things for us. Oh, okay, see, that's what I was asking. What did you do special today, then?
Get ready for church.
Get ready for church. Did they do it without complaining?
Savannah did.
Okay, then we're getting ready for church, okay? How about you, Caleb? What have you done special so far today? You didn't pick your room up this morning. Give me a break. I don't buy that one. Don't feed him trouble, Savannah. Not today. Not this morning. I asked, what special did he do today? I mean, John's special today. He came and got his mom, and he's sitting here with her this morning, and he's even been taking her picking on him. Mr. John Hines back there, sitting back there with Jeannie. You sit a couple rows in front of you there? Oh. See, he's done something special. And you guys heard James being special this morning, didn't you? Or were you guys not paying attention? Do you remember what James said? What did he say? You don't know. Can you repeat it now, James? Or was that just an on-the-spot thing?
Just more of an on-the-spot.
Oh, okay. Okay, so it's in, it's out, it's gone. Congratulations, Faith. You'll have a great day today, I see. You at least got Jessica. And he got ready for church. Special is not biting your sister's thumb off and you guys happen to go to the hospital, okay? That's not special, okay? They don't need that today, okay? They got other things planned, I'm sure. So, it's Mother's Day. And every year for Mother's Day, we have things that we ask you guys to hand out, to help give to all the mothers who are here. And this year, we have one that's called Be Still and Know. It's got a devotion in it for each day, and it's got a journaling place in it for being able to journal and write some notes about this day's verse and message and such. And would you guys help us pass them out? To all the women? I don't know. Let me see. No, there's a couple you can leave out. But that's for you to find out. You have no idea. And they're not all sitting in one section. So you got to guess. No, you don't got to guess. Is that enough?
No.
There's only three of them. That is correct. Oh, goodness. Maybe I should have opened them already. There we go. Here you go, Savannah. There's some. There you go, man. We got a whole bunch more. We got plenty. Make sure all the moms get them. Cindy up front here. See, you guys didn't even get the closest one to you. Does anyone need one for mothers that they will be seeing later today?
Never met the woman before. I wasn't expecting it.
And that's the way she was to everybody. She expected her kids and grandkids to bring strangers home to the table, bring friends home to the table. If there weren't some non-family members at a gathering, she wasn't happy. She just was the most welcoming person I've ever met.
Amen. Amen. Yeah, that's the kind of thing I'm talking about. Anybody else? Tim.
I get asked this question all the time. How can you live by your mother-in-law? And I always tell people, do you know my mother-in-law? Because if you knew her, you want to live by her too.
Amen.
She's been very encouraging for me.
Makes a great potato salad.
Whenever I'm having a bad day or down day, you should eat this potato salad.
Amen. Amen. Yes, Raymond.
There was a gal that lived a little ways east of my mom and dad. I considered her my second mother. Every time I'd get a little boogered up, I used to go down and help them, and she just like mom was there, she loved us all, and she took care of us. And Marlene, you know who I'm talking about. Marlene's mother now. She was one great gal.
Amen. Amen. You know, those are the people in our lives that really make the differences, aren't they? They're the people that show us that it is not just a cold, cruel world waiting to take us down to the grave. Because in all honesty, without these experiences, without these peoples in our lives, that's exactly what this world is and what this world becomes. And that's why it was so important that God came to walk amongst us. At this time, let's go to our readings.
Must be preached to all nations, beginning in Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things, and I myself will send upon you what my Father has promised. But you must wait in the city until the power from above comes down upon you. Then he led them out of the city as far as Bethany, where he raised his hands and blessed them. As he was blessing them, he departed from them and was taken up into heaven. They worshipped him and went back into Jerusalem, filled with great joy, and spent all their time in the temple giving thanks to God. God's word for God's people.
Our New Testament reading is from the book of Acts. It's a continuation of Luke's writings. And we start with verse 1. In the first book, he's referring to Luke. In the first book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus did and taught from the beginning until the day when he was taken up to heaven, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. After his suffering, he presented himself alive to them by many convincing proofs, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God, while saying to them, he ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. This, he said, is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. So when they had come together, they asked him, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom of Israel? He replied, it is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all the Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing up towards heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. Lord, bless these your holy words and we who hear them. The ascension of Jesus Christ. This is Ascension Sunday. Technically, last Thursday marks 40 days after Easter, and that it would, in many places, is Ascension Day, and they have their services for recognizing that Jesus ascended into heaven and will come back again. Most of these services take place outside because, well, that's where he lifted up from. And that's where we can look to see if he's returning. This is one of two reasons why Jesus and God say, when you're down, when you're in trouble, when you feel broken, when you feel beaten, when you feel as if all things are lost, look up and remember from where your redemption comes. It's not just him sitting upon the throne. It's also him standing at the door waiting to return when the last have been brought in. It's a harvest thing, remember? Jesus said the harvest was great, the workers were few, and get to work. He told us everything we needed for doing what we're supposed to do. We have his word. It goes with us everywhere we go, or it can. And the parts that are written on our hearts does, don't they? Those things that are so ingrained in a part of us go with us wherever we go, no matter what we do. It's like the words of our mothers, right? They stay with us. Those words of encouragement, get up, brush yourself off, you can do this. Try it again. How many times do you have to say that to James, right?
Quite a few.
Quite a few. Yeah, James, you're just here this morning and she's here, so you get on the spot a little bit.
Okay.
I've also got Wade and Maya here, so I'm sure they can get picked on some today, too. Okay, now, you know how it is. But James, all of us can have that said about us, can't we? Every one of us can say there are times when we have fallen and we've needed help back up. There's times when we had boo-boos that needed healed, times where they were physical, times where they were emotional. Times when they're spiritual. Emotional and physical can usually be taken care of by others here on earth. That's one of the wondrous things why God gives us others, to fulfill those needs and help us feel family and community and togetherness. But our spiritual can only come from God. That's the only source of things spiritual, period. So if we're not continuously looking up and renewing that source from God, our spiritual levels continue to drop and continue to drop and continue to drop. Now what happens to us as spiritual beings, because we are spiritual beings, when that spiritual level in us drops? We stop being concerned about others, don't we? We stop worrying about others. We stop even smiling at others. In fact, we get to the point where we start cursing others, because we have no blessings in us to give out. That's what happens to the person that's all alone, isn't it? That's really the most devastating part of being all alone. Is that you've got no community. You've got no family. You've got nothing that's going to help you take care of those things that the physical requires. And that's the other reason the spiritual is so important. Because let's face it, there's times when the physical falls short, right? And it's not because of something they did or something because you did. It's because your spiritual is out of whack. And that is the biggest thing with us as Christians as we wander around this world, is our spiritual is out of whack. It's not aligned. It's not straight with the mission of God. And that's pretty simple. Jesus told us to do what? Love one another. That's our mission. Totally. Nothing else. It's not to make sure that people believe Jesus ascended on the cloud and that he's going to come back on them. That's not our mission. That's God's goal. God will put that on people's hearts and warm their hearts and bring their hearts to him. When you first learned of God, did you agree with everything that was in the Apostles' Creed? Or did some of it seem really, really strange? Some of it seemed really strange. Especially whenever you got to the part after you said, I believe in the Holy Spirit. Right? Because then most of you know, I believe in the Holy Catholic Church. And some people can't say that out loud because they think that means they're pledging allegiance to the Pope. Do you know you're Catholic? What? Yeah, you're Catholic if you're United Methodist. Catholic means universal. Okay? The universal church. If you're United Methodist, you are very Catholic because, well, Methodist Episcopal, the Brethren, the Evangelical Association, the United Evangelical Brotherhood. We're also in connection with the Episcopalians, with the Lutherans. Well, with a couple of types of Lutherans. One doesn't like us yet. We're even in connection with a couple of Baptists. We're even in, you name a denomination, we have been in talks to be in connection. We're actually in connection with Roman Catholics. They don't always see it that way, but one of their councils agreed, those who hold the tenets of the Apostles' Creed are Catholic and connected.